Dear students, this is heat engine. The working substance is absorbing Q1 amount of heat energy from the hot reservoir at higher temperature and absorbing the heat energy, it is doing some work by pushing the piston. And the remaining heat energy is rejected to the surroundings. As an example, here we have taken some numerical values. It has absorbed 10 joules of heat energy. Out of the 10 joules, 7 joules are utilized to do work, and the remaining 3 joules of heat energy is rejected to the surroundings. See, 3 joules wasted to the surroundings. This wastage should be minimized. This wastage should be removed. Naturally, we wish that thing only, because this is wasted to the surroundings. And see, whatever heat energy you draw from hot reservoir, the entire heat energy must be converted to work, and there should be no wastage. That is your ambition. But second law of thermodynamics says that ambition can never be fulfilled. See, here 10 joules of heat energy cannot be converted into 10 joules of work, and that is not a limitation of your engine. It is a limitation placed by the nature. You can improvise your device. Even though you improvise your device, you never make it convert the heat completely into work. No improvised engine can do that, because that is not a limitation of an engine. It is a limitation posed by the nature. And that law of nature is called as second law of thermodynamics. Second law of thermodynamics tells that Q2 never you can make it zero, or you can never make Q1 is equal to W. Here, W means what? Let us see. We can write an energy equation here. Q1 is drawn. A part of it is used to do work. Remaining rejected to surroundings. So, Q1 is equal to W plus Q2. Or W is equal to Q1 minus Q2. In place of W, you can write Q1 minus Q2 by Q1. Q1 by Q1 1 minus Q2 by Q1. Q2 can never be equal to 0, because so that is said by second law. Q2 can never become 0. Always there will be some amount of heat energy will be wasted to the surroundings. Or in another way, or total heat cannot be converted into work. Total heat cannot be converted into work. Here, a strange thing is, by doing work, heat energy can be produced. For example, this is a ground. You take a seed and you rub it against the ground, heat energy is produced. What amount of work you do, that is converted into heat. If you touch the seed, you can feel the heat produced. So here, the strange thing is, suppose you did 10 joules of work in moving the seed. The 10 joules of, by doing 10 joules of work, you can get 10 joules of heat. It means work done, the total work can be converted into heat, but total heat cannot be converted into work. That is second law of thermodynamics. So for this purpose, the statement is given by Kelvin Planck. Let us see here. No process is possible whose sole result is the absorption of heat from a reservoir and the complete conversion of the heat into work. Complete conversion of heat into work cannot be done. That is second law. Now let us consider fridge. How its efficiency, that is a coefficient of performance, is defined. Heat extracted from the cold reservoir. Exactly opposite to that. Q2. How much work is done on the system, W. Heat drawn from the cold reservoir is 6 joules. Work done on the system is 4 joules, greater than 1. So for a fridge, coefficient of performance is always greater than 1. But here, in case of fridge, what is our wish? In case of heat engine, the total heat absorbed must be converted into work. And here what is your wish? Here my wish is, see, to pump heat from inside fridge to outside fridge, we need some electric power. That electric power, see here, now I am drawing, each second 4 joules of electric energy is required for this purpose. So this is very large. This must be decreased. Okay. This must be decreased to 3 or 2 or 1. But it cannot be decreased to 0. Without electric power, suppose current is not there, your fridge won't work. Without electric power, you cannot pump heat energy from inside fridge to outside fridge. That is second law of thermodynamics. And the statement is given by Clausius scientist. No process is possible whose sole result is the transfer of heat from a colder object to a hotter object. It is impossible for a self-acting machine, unaided by any external agency, to transfer heat from a body at lower temperature to a body at higher temperature. This is clear. Unaided by any external agency. Here, external agency is electric power we make use of. So without its aid, without its help, you cannot pump heat from lower temperature to higher temperature. So that is second law of thermodynamics. if you could pump without external external work, then if W is zero, then W will be zero without external electric power. Suppose your fridge runs with no electric power. Suppose then W is zero. Then COP is Q2 by zero, infinity. But COP never becomes infinity according to second law. Similarly, for heat engine, what is our wish? Whatever heat you draw from hot reservoir, the entire heat energy must be converted to work. Suppose you have drawn 10 joules of heat energy. All the 10 joules, absorbing the 10 joules of heat energy, 10 joules of work must be done. Then what happens to efficiency? See, 10 joules of heat energy is drawn and the total heat is converted to work. Then efficiency becomes 1, or in percentage, into 100, 100%. So our second law of thermodynamics tells that efficiency of heat engine can never be 100%. So second law of thermodynamics tells that heat engine cannot be 100% efficient. Similarly, fridge coefficient of performance cannot be infinity. Now let us consider significance of the second law of thermodynamics. So according to Clausius, what is the meaning of his statement? Without help of external agency, heat cannot be pumped from a body of lower temperature to a body of higher temperature. Or heat on its own cannot flow from cold body to hot body. So when a hot body is kept in touch with cold body, heat flows from hot body to cold body. But it doesn't flow from cold body to hot body. It means it is not reversible. This is a naturally occurring process, and the spontaneous process of nature are irreversible. They obey in one direction only. Second, Kelvin-Planck statement. Work done can be totally converted into heat, but heat energy cannot be totally converted into work. See, work can be totally converted into heat, but heat totally cannot be converted into work. See, again, this naturally occurring process is obeying only in one direction. The spontaneous process of nature, this is spontaneous process of nature, and this is not irreversible. Suppose 10 joules of work is done, 10 joules of work can be converted into 10 joules of heat, but 10 joules of heat cannot be converted into 10 joules of work. If this is not reversible, so the naturally occurring processes are irreversible. To explain the law of reversibility in nature, second law is formulated.